Steve Dotto here. How the heck you doing this fine day? Me? I'm feeling that connected nature that can only come from being part of a robust social network. Today we are speaking of LinkedIn, and specifically we're talking about LinkedIn having released a new version of their mobile app for both iOS and Android. That's what we're going to be looking at today on Dotto Tech. The folks at LinkedIn have been on a kind of constant reinvention of themselves over the past few years. You may have noticed, those of you who certainly participate in LinkedIn. And one of the areas that they've really been beefing up is trying to create a better engagement in the mobile space. And their newest version of their iOS app and Android app is a testament to the changes that are happening at LinkedIn. And we get a real good feeling of kind of where LinkedIn is going and what we can do now with LinkedIn through this mobile app or through this new integration. Now, the first thing that you're going to notice when you install the mobile app is you've got a very, for lack of better term, Facebook-y feeling to the homepage because it looks pretty much just like Facebook, with a series of posts. We know that one thing that LinkedIn has been trying to do is trying to create more conversation. They're trying to create more social sharing and more engagement in their posts and in their articles, in the whole publishing space. And this new app here on the iPhone and on the Android phone really shows us exactly what we're talking about. And yeah, I suspect that if you just picked up your phone and started reading through, you'd have trouble telling whether or not you were in Facebook or LinkedIn. Of course, that's all going to end when we take a look at some of the other features within it. So the publishing and reading of posts is kind of been brought right to the front page of the app. But then as we go through it, we go in and we can take a look at our own profile, which tells us about the different engagement that people are having. Now we're starting to feel more of the kind of LinkedIn-y feel, not quite so much Facebook. So here we see all of the different people that have liked our posts and endorsed us and those sorts of common things that are happening on your profile. As we move through, there's a full messaging app. And again, kind of following down Facebook's path of having a messaging app right within the mobile app. This gives us an opportunity to communicate with everybody who wants to communicate with us. But I think the area that you're going to find most interesting, other than maybe the homepage with all of the posts, is the My Network area. So this is where you're going to go in. And I think one of the nice things about the app is you're going to be able to quickly, by tapping on the people icon in the very top, you're going to be able to jump over into that invitation and connection space so you can see who exactly is inviting you to connect with them, and you can do the connections right from here. This is the sort of thing that I'd like to be able to do really quickly while I'm, you know, waiting for the water to boil for a pot of tea or something like that, be able to go through and make a few connections. And oh, name drop time, look who wants to be my friend on LinkedIn. Kim Garst, yes, the queen of Twitter wants to be my friend, so I've just said yes, and of course I can go in. And the key thing that you're going to want to be able to do, of course, is you're going to want to be able to respond to it so you can send a message thanking her very much. That's awesome, Kim. Thanks so much. Looking forward to connecting with you here as well! Exclamation mark. All of my good friends who are experts on LinkedIn say that we should always, always, always use personal messages as we're connecting with people in this space. So there we have the ability to manage our connections. If we go over on the other side of this window and tap on the other person icon with a little plus next to it, we can go through and we can research and we can build our network out and we can find new contacts there. So that's a proactive way as opposed to being reactive. And then this center section, which kind of gives you an update on the people who are your connections. And I think this is going to be pretty cool as well, because you can quickly just browse through what's happening in different people's lives. So this is basically looking at the people who you're connected to, having them, their updates kind of being brought up as far as, and us being able to see what updates and what new information and new relevant information they're putting forward. So again, a nice mobile feel with the ability to swipe back and forth on those sorts of updates. And then finally, we have a search function, which will allow you to go through and search for almost anything within your account. But I also wanted to show you, while we're here, I'm going to go back to the home button, because there is this other area here, which is the LinkedIn apps. This is a suite of tools that LinkedIn is bringing to the table outside of the social network that is LinkedIn that we might be interested in using. They have a job search tool there, LinkedIn groups, which they've kind of been on and off relationship with LinkedIn groups, but we see them there. SlideShare, lynda.com, acquisitions from the outside that are nice apps that have social sharing connotations to them, access to them, and of course, oh, that's SlideShare. Lynda.com is training on almost anything under the sun, so you get a really good idea of the integrated apps that LinkedIn is bringing to the table, and I think we will obviously see this particular area grow. Overall, I think that their new app is a nice mobile app that that reflects what we like to do in mobile, as well as giving us a good access to LinkedIn's traditional and new features, the ones that they're trying to grow as we go along. So I think it's well worth downloading. It's free, and there are going to be things that if you are a LinkedIn user, you're going to find some real extra value in being able to do a lot of the different tasks in mobile, especially those little snippets of time that you have when you can just go through and make a few connections or read a few posts or something along that line. Well, I hope that you found today's video to be useful. Now, remember, there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to our channel. Second, as I encourage you to subscribe to our newsletter, then you'll hear about all of our live webinars and events and free trainings that we offer on a regular basis. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded channel brought to you through the support of our friends at Patreon. If you want to know what's involved in supporting Dotto Tech and how it benefits both you and I, then I encourage you to drop by our Patreon page and have a look. Until next time, I am Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.